So API manufacturers must employ suitable cleaning procedures to avoid the cross-contamination between two different products. The API manufacturers must control the carryover of previous products below its acceptable level. Now, what is meaning of acceptable level? It is nothing but the MACO or MACO, that is maximum allowable carryover of previous product into the next product. So as per the guideline published by APIC, they have given three different approaches to calculate the MACO. The first one is by using the therapeutic daily dose approach. The second one is by using the toxicological data. And the third one is by using general PPM limit. And they have given certain calculation formulas for all these three different approaches. So in this video, I am going to explain to you how this calculation formula that APIC has given into this guideline onto the page number 9 for the MACO, that is MACO is equal to TDD previous into MBS next divided by SF divided by TDD next, must have been arrived at. So the purpose of making today's video is to explain how this calculation formula must have been derived at. And this is the calculation formula for MACO based on therapeutic daily dose approach. So now let us try to design the calculation formula for the MACO based on to the therapeutic daily dose. And here are the details. See, this is the guidelines reference. It is guidance on the reference guidelines name I am just reading for you. That is guidance on aspects of cleaning validation in active pharmaceutical ingredient plants. And the source is what? Active Pharmaceutical Ingredient Committee, that is APIC. So in case if your API is going to be used for, let us say, oral solid dosage form preparation and the manufacturing, then as per this guideline for OSD, the 1000th of TDD of previous product is allowed into TDD of next product. Now this statement is very important, and I am going to explain to you what is the meaning of this one important statement. And believe me, this statement alone is going to help us in building the calculation formula for the MACO based on TDD. So let us assume that the previous product is telmisartan. Okay, telmisartan API is our previous product. Now what is the TDD, therapeutic daily dose of the telmisartan? As it is a previous product, I will say that the TDDP, okay, that is therapeutic daily dose of previous product, and in this case, as it is telmisartan, it is 160 milligram, right? It is 160 milligram. Now what is our next product? Okay, so the next product is, let us say, metformin hydrochloride. And do you know the therapeutic daily dose of metformin? It is 2550 milligram, and I denoted it by N just to identify it is the TDD of next product. It is the TDD of now the next product. You are going to clean the telmisartan. You are going to clean the traces, residues of the telmisartan for the manufacturing of your metformin batch, right? So as per this calculation formula, let us understand how much mass of telmisartan is allowed into metformin, right? That is the purpose of understanding the MACO formula. So can I say that, you know, the 160 divided by 1000 is actually what? 1000th part of TDD of Telmisartan? Yes or no? Yeah, 1000th part of the Telmisartan. And this much amount of Telmisartan is actually allowable as per this guideline into the TDT of next product. So what is the TDT of next product? Which is 2550 milligram, right? So I will say that this much amount of Telmisartan will be allowed into 2550 milligram of metformin SCL. Okay, I hope you are with me so far. Let us now substitute these figures by their actual meaning. So what is 160? This 160 is nothing but TDD previous, right? Now what is the 1000? This 1000 stands for the safety factors. The 1000 stands for the safety factors, which is 1000th part in case of OSD that we are discussing right now. So this much amount of Telmisartan is allowable into the 2550 milligram. So what is the 2550 milligram of the ACL? It is nothing but the TDD next. It is nothing but the TDD next. Now this is a very important equation we arrived at based on this very important statement, right? So our interest is not just to identify the allowable carryover into one dose of the metformin, but into the entire batch of the metformin hydrochloride. Into the entire batch of the metformin hydrochloride. So can I write this equation now? So how much milligram, and that will be x milligram of the Telmisartan will be allowed into the total batch size of the next product. And I will say it is a BSN, the batch size of the next product. It can be, let us say, 1000 kilogram or 100 kilogram, whatever it may be. Okay, so we got two required very important equation. So what is the value of xmg? What is the value of xmg? I will arrive at, and it is with a very simple cross multiplication. It will be now TDD previous, right? Have a look over here. That is TDD previous. TDD previous into what is that? Into BS next, that is the batch size of the next product, right? Divided by now what it will be, right? Just understand here the equations, right? This XMG into TDD will come at the left side. So when it moves to right side, this TDDN will become the at the denominator, right? So it will become TDD next, and here the SF, the safety factor, was already available. So now this is my equation. I hope you must be able to rearrange the equation very easily. Simple cross multiplication between these two equations. Okay, just perform the cross multiplication of these two equations, right? And you will be able to arrive at the final equation. You will be able to arrive at the final equation, that is x milligram is equal to TDD previous into BSN divided by SF into TDD next. Now what is x milligram over here? What is the x milligram? So x milligram is actually your macro. X milligram is nothing but your macro value that is allowable into not only the therapeutic daily dose of your metformin, but into the entire batch of the metformin. There is one more term we need to understand. See, this batch size, you know, this batch size terms makes a very important sense. So please tell me, in what case you will have smaller macro? During which case you will have the smaller macro? The case will be when batch size is maximum, or when batch size is minimum. So what is the answer? In what situation you will have the smaller value for the x? And you can easily understand that if the BS is smaller, minimum, then you are going to have the minimum macro value. And it's always preferred to have the minimum macro value, the minimum carryover of the previous product into the next one. So this BS, the batch size, is always must be taken as the minimum batch size. MBS stands for the minimum batch size. So in case if you have a metformin batch size ranging from 100 kg to 1000 kg into your manufacturing plant, then you must calculate the macro for the metformin by taking 100 kilogram, which is the minimum batch size of the metformin into your manufacturing plant. And then this is the now the final calculation formula. This is the final calculation formula for the macro, that is therapeutic daily dose of the previous product into the minimum batch size of the next product divided by safety factors divided by therapeutic daily dose of the next product. So let us go back to the calculation formula given by this guideline, and this is the calculation formula. Okay, and let me show you whether we have also arrived at this similar calculation formula or not. Okay, so let me try to show you here. And here it is. See, the macro is equal to, that is our x milligram, the TDD previous, we also got the TDD previous into MBS, minimum batch size of the next. Look here, MBS for the next product, the safety factors, and they divided by TDD next. So by using the simple calculation steps, we could able to derive the actual calculation formula for the macro based on to the therapeutic daily dose. Right, so I hope you must have understood the logic behind going through all these stages and then arriving at the calculation formula for the macro. Thank you very much for watching this video, and I will meet you soon with such kind of very informative and useful videos. Till then, take care and bye bye. See you soon.